Good morning and welcome to St. Mary. Today is the Solemnity of the Nativity of St. John the Baptist. Today's Mass is being offered for Anna Monahan at the request of the Monahan family. A man was sent from God, whose name was John. He came to testify to the Lord, to prepare a people fit for the Lord.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who raised up St. John the Baptist to make ready a nation fit for Christ the Lord, give your people, we pray, the grace of spiritual joys, and direct the hearts of all the faithful into the way of salvation and peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear me, O coastlands, listen, O distant peoples. The Lord called me from birth. From my mother's womb, he gave me my name. He made of me a sharp-edged sword and concealed me in the shadow of his arm. He made me a polished arrow, and his quiver he hid me. You are my servant, he said to me, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Though I thought I had toiled in vain and for nothing, uselessly spent my strength, yet my reward is with the Lord, my recompense is with my God. For now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, he says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I praise you, for I am wonderfully made.
I praise you, for I am wonderfully made.
O Lord, you have probed me. You know me. You know when I sit and when I stand. You understand my thoughts from afar. My journeys and my rest you scrutinize. With all my ways you are familiar. I praise you, for I am wonderfully made. Truly, you have formed my inmost being. You knit me in my mother's womb. I give you thanks that Of him God testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish. From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, has brought to Israel a Savior, Jesus. John heralded his coming by proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, what do you suppose that I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet. My brothers, sons of the family of Abraham, and those others among you who are God-fearing, to us this word of salvation has been sent. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today the church celebrates the Nativity of St. John the Baptist. Not that you want to know this, but today it's 6 months before Christmas Eve. And it's not a coincidence that the church places these solemnities, the Solemnity of John the Baptist on June 24th, and the Solemnity of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, December 24th. And even in following the summer solstice and the winter solstice, it's very interesting because with the summer solstice, we know that little by little, the days will be shorter. And that's why, of course, John says, he must increase, I must decrease. And in the winter solstice, after the winter solstice, that first day of winter, then the days get a little bit longer and longer and longer, that Christ may increase. So even by nature, even by the whole economy of salvation, how beautiful these solemnities are put before us to reflect and to really understand this wonderful man, John the Baptist, the precursor for Christ, to announce his coming. And not only to announce his coming as if it's just an announcement, something that you say a couple times during the day. It's more than that, isn't it? It's a whole way of life. It's preparing a whole people for Christ. And I think sometimes we don't realize what John was doing. He was allowing Israel to prepare very, very much for the coming of Christ. Even John's appearance attracted people. Not that he was so attractive in himself. I'm sure he was not eye candy for people. It was what he wore and what he ate. He wore camel's hair and he had honey and locusts. It's kind of a tough guy. I guess he needed to be tough to live in those kind of conditions and to brave not only the elements, but to brave also the people's comments and their reaction. To be prepared and to be tough like that. No wonder on the day of our confirmation we were told that we were soldiers of Christ. No wonder we who remember, especially us here present, received a little blow on the cheek by the bishop to become really that soldier who was to announce Christ. No matter where we go and what kind of circumstance, no matter what circle of people we were in, to bring a people closer to the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ. So today, as the church celebrates this solemnity, and you know that today it ranks the highest of all the churchful rank. Solemnity is the highest. It equates itself with Sunday. Although today is not a day of obligation, but it still ranks on a Sunday level because you hear the Gloria prayed, there's two readings, and then after this homily there'll be the resuscitation of the creed. So it's a wonderful day to just to take back and to look at this man, John the Baptist, even the way that he was born. Remember, Elizabeth was already really of advanced age. It was almost, to many people, that was the miracle, which it is. That was the miracle, that this woman was to carry a child at her age. And not only that, as scripture tells us, normally it would be Zachariah, named after his father, right? So that would be probably the normal course of events, but no. His name was going to be John, just like the archangel Gabriel said that he was going to be John. Do you see how the connection between the birth of John the Baptist and the birth of Christ? John would say, before I was born, he existed, right? Before I was born, John said, he already existed. John knew that. John knew that was in the plan of God, that Jesus Christ is the Word becoming flesh among us. That Jesus already existed. In the beautiful triune God, God is Father, Son, and Spirit. Before the world even began, Christ was there. And so for you and for me, this solemnity holds much reflection about whom God calls and chooses for, of course, a great work, and how our work individually corresponds to the great work of announcing the message. Don't you think that today more than ever this message needs to be made known? That is the message of Christ in the gospel. You know, we're in 2020, and some days I feel like we're barbarians, that we have no intellect, that we're not thinking correctly. And I'm not saying us as a total people, but a good portion. Some has neglected God out of existence. Now to take down statues of Christ because he was a white supremacist. Could you imagine? All of these things that you and I, like John the Baptist, must speak and announce before Christ. I think there's much work today more than ever. I think today, more than when we were in elementary school, do we have to renounce the work of God? So let's try to remember everything that we were taught in our younger days about the gospel, about Christ, about devotion, about Mass, about the sacraments, and let's hold that of highest importance to us. The world needs God. It's hungering for God. It lacks the grace, because if it had grace, how beautiful it would be. Grace building upon grace. So let us decrease as he increases. Let us make sure that we step aside so that Christ can fill us, so that we can continue the work of salvation. And may everything that we do begin by him, and by him be happily completed. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For those who proclaim the gospel, may God provide them wisdom and courage. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead nations and peoples, may they be guided by the mercy and compassion of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those burdened by illness and poor health, may they be led and healed by the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of this community, may God's love inspire and increase in us our varied gifts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they experience true peace in the arms of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Luke Carroll, Sue Capella, Jackie Carmen, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Anna Monahan, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Towers, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like John the Baptist did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you, if they're in accord with your holy will. We ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
you are God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Praise to the brothers, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And the Lord accepts the sacrifice in your hands. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We place these offerings on our altar, O Lord, to celebrate the fitting honor, with fitting honor the Nativity of Him, who both foretold the coming of the world Savior and pointed him out when he came. Who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In his precursor, John the Baptist, we praise your great glory. For you consecrated him for a singular honor among those born of women. His birth brought great joy, even in the womb he left for joy at the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the Lamb of redemption. And to make holy the flowing waters, he baptized the very author of baptism, and was privileged to bear him supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. So, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
The body of Christ. pray.
Happy feast of the banquet of the heavenly plan, we pray, O Lord, that finding joy in the nativity of St. John the Baptist, your church may know as the author of her rebirth, the Christ whose coming John foretold, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Now may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everyone.
You too, Father.
Saint Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
And give